All right. So now we go back once more to whomever can sign customs documents, CBP documents for drawbacks. And basically you have a list of entities and you have columns which says, okay, those guys can sign this and this, but those guys can only sign those documents, all right? So pretty much you see the usual list of individuals and persons who can sign. So president, vice president, secretary, treasurer, or any other employee. So those guys are by default because they're officers of the company, we're talking about corporation, or employee that is legally authorized to bind the corporation by, and this can be done by resolution or by some kind of power of attorney form. A full partner, all in partnership. So if it's a limited partner, there can be an issue if that limited partner is not, if his limitation does not cover the scope of customs business, so that will not do. The owner of a sole proprietorship, if one is engaging in drawback, right, the owner doing drawback for himself or herself also qualifies, all right? And here we're talking about drawback entry, certificate of delivery related to drawback entry, other certificates and supporting documentation. Individual action on his or her own behalf, which is pretty much this guy, right? Well, it can also be attributable to the company. A licensed customs broker with a power of attorney. So with a power of attorney, recall that for to engage in customs business, you have to have three things if you're going to engage in customs business as a customs broker. First, you have to have the license, either corporate or individual. Second, you have to have a permit. Third, you have to have a power of attorney. What about the permit? What about the permit for licensed customs broker as far as drawback is concerned? So the first question we have to ask is, does drawback constitute a customs business? And the answer is located in definitions 111.1, which pretty much define customs business. And yes, drawback or those duties or preparation of drawback or activities relating to preparation of drawback is customs business. So that's a goal, right? So since it is customs business, then the drawback is customs business. So if you're doing it as a customs broker, then you have to have those three things. You have to have a permit, you have to have a power of attorney. But we saw that there is only like four ports who are doing drawback. So does it mean that you, let's say you are somewhere in Anchorage, Alaska. You have a permit to conduct customs business in Anchorage, Alaska. Does it mean that you have to get another permit? Well, the answer, you don't have to venture out too far to get that answer. So this was 111.2, license and district permit required, right? For filing drawback claims, a broker granted a permit for one district may file drawback claims manually or electronically at the drawback office that has been designated by customs, so we're talking about those four ports, for the purpose of filing drawback claims, and may represent his client before that office in matters concerning those claims, even though the broker does not have a permit for the district in which the drawback office is located. In other words, no. If you are a licensed customs broker engaging in customs business in Anchorage, Alaska, you do not need to file to get a permit in one of those four ports which have the drawback office locations. So in other words, you do not need to get the guy in Alaska or the lady in Alaska does not, they do not have to obtain, apply for the permit in those ports for to file drawback. Just the fact that they have a permit in Anchorage will do. That's for the drawback. So the drawback is kind of an exception, right, to the permit, the general permit rule. What about the power of attorney? Is there such an exception to the power of attorney? So powers of attorney, they're found in part 141, right? Subpart C. So this is the general rule which applies to pretty much across the board. That's the third requirement. Before, this is the buzzword, before transacting customs business in the same, in the name of his principal, custom house broker is required to obtain a valid power of attorney to do so. Recall, this is the old phrase. It has been amended in 1980s, I believe 1984, to instead of custom house broker, we now use the phrase customs, licensed customs broker. So power of attorney is a must. The district permit where you file a drawback claim is not required as long as you have a permit within your municipality. All right. So that's about licensed broker with the power of attorney. All right. Drawback entries may be signed by any of the following persons except vice president. So we saw that corporate officer. So that's by default. The owner of a sole proprietorship, yes. So we're looking for exception, right? A licensed customs broker with a power of attorney. So here it was without, but here we already have a power of attorney. So this one, C is good. An unlicensed drawback consultant. So what did we talk about before when we talked about customs business, right? Drawback, engaging in drawback, or even drawback-related activities, what does it constitute? It constitutes customs business within the meaning of 111.2, right? I'm sorry, 111.1, which defines customs business to include drawback and related activities that relate to the preparation of drawback. And if it's customs business, you have to have a license. You have to have a customs broker license. You have to have a permit. For the drawback, we have an exception. You don't have to have that particular permit, but generally speaking, you do. And you have to have a power of attorney. So, unlicensed drawback consultant, if they engage in drawback-related preparation activities or drawback filing, they engage in customs business. So, is that going to be a problem? Yes, it's going to be a problem because they need a license to conduct customs business. So, D is an exception. Any employee of the business entity with a power of attorney, so as we mentioned before, 140-146, power of attorney is required. Without it, you have no authority to do so on behalf of someone else, unless you're doing it for yourself. So, power of attorney is a must. Okay, now, so here D is the correct answer because it is an exception.